Welcome back, students. This is the fifth lecture of aerial photogrammetry. What we have seen in the last time, what is the stereo vision? And if you see the two positions, the O position and this is the O dash. And if I say capital B is the distance in the air between two positions of the aircraft, we call it as airbase distance. And let us say here is the datum, this is the A point above datum, and let us say another point B. So if you want to know what is the elevation difference between two points, so to calculate this we will take the help of what we have seen in the last lecture, what is the parallax for the A and what is the parallax for the B point. So what is the parallax? It's an apparent movement of the image from one point to another point. So XA is the distance from the principal point to the A point. What you can see here is the A point. XA dash is the point when the aircraft has moved to the new position O dash. The same point, if it is observed or taken from the new position, the same point we will say that is the A dash. So the new K dash is the new principal point. From this to this is nothing but your X A dash. So this is the minus sign, but if you see this is the algebraic sum. So PA is equal to is the XA plus this is the XA dash. This is the actual. Similarly, this one is the also algebraic sum XB plus XB dash. Now if you see the difference between two parallax points, because we want to know what is the difference between these two points A and B. So therefore we want to know what is the difference in the parallax. So difference in parallax is shown as a PA and PB, and these two difference in the parallax A and B we denote as delta P. Now if we say the height difference between these two is the difference, if this is the general formula, I have skipped some of the steps here just to calculate HA, what is the height A. So if I say this is the HA is equal to I'll just write it the capital A. So here it will be HA, and B, that is the constant distance, F, this is the focal length which is also constant. Now what is the P? Is the parallax. So if I say this is the capital A, so what it indicates, if I want to know what is the height of A, that is the A point with respect to the data we want to calculate, so you can calculate H. What is H? Is the flying height from the datum to the exposure point, which is known actually if we want to calculate the height. So then all the right hand side, the parameters, they should be known. Then we can calculate what is the HA. So if you want to calculate what is the HA, that means all the parameters on right hand side, that should be known. Similarly, if you want to calculate what is the HB, so HB similarly can be written as, so instead of PA, there will be what is the PB will be there. Okay, going. So HA is equal to, if I say what I have explained just now, HA is equal to H minus BF upon PA, and HB is equal to H minus BF. Okay. So what we want, what is the elevation difference between A and B? So if I say this is the actually H we want. So this can be calculated, if I can say H or if I say this is the delta H. So delta H is equal to taking the difference of these two, simpler. So writing their respective forms. So you will find that only the variable parameter is the PB and PA. Okay. So this H and this H, as this is being associated with the P and PB, so therefore this BF and this BF, they are not going to cancel out. Only the single term is H, and H is here, which is canceling out. So therefore, if you say this is the minus sign and this is minus minus plus, so therefore this term comes first here, minus BF upon P. Okay. So now here the BF is the common, and 1 upon PA minus 1 upon PB. Now, if I simplify this, finally I'll get BF into PB minus PA divided by PB into PA. But what is this one? This is nothing but the delta P. That is the difference between the two parallax, right? Back. So this BF, that is replaced by this value BH. Okay. So therefore, this value simplifies delta H is equal to H minus HA. So this is your HA. Now this value becomes 0. So where your HA, you will be putting this is equal to 0. So this is the new simplified form of your delta H. So what if you want to calculate delta H? So delta H is nothing but HB minus HA. So what is the HB minus HA? So this is the equation HB minus HA. So but HA is equal to 0. So simply I can say that is the HB. Okay, so height of B with respect to A, what is the meaning of this? So in this equation, if you see, there is the H square and here H term and here. So again, your equation simplified, delta H is equal to delta P into H divided by delta P plus H. So this is the final equation you should remember. So delta H, or now we can see simply small h, because there is no more A or B terms, because we are considering with respect to the A. So there is no point to again indicating HB. So your datum is with respect to the A only, whose elevation is 0. So simply you can say delta H, or simply H, is equal to delta P. So what is the delta P? So if you measure on the photographs XA and XA dash, taking the difference or algebraic sum of this. Similarly, PB and PB dash, and taking the PA minus PB, that will give the delta P value. So this value you can calculate. This value is known to you. Again, this value and this value you have to measure photo base distance. So how you can calculate base distance? You have to identify the point whose height is to be measured, and then taking the in the first photographs with respect to the first principal point and the second principal point, the distance between the two points, and taking the average of these two, that will give the base distance. So that's how you can calculate height of any point above the datum. Please note that the point datum here is not the means level. The datum is here the base of any building. So this is the stereoscope, which is considered to measure the base distance. There are two types. One is the mirror stereoscope, and another one is the pocket stereoscope. Having light in weight, we call it the pocket stereoscope, but mirror stereoscope has somewhat more weightage. And secondly, it has it is called as a mirror stereoscope because there are two mirrors, we call it the as good as your binoculars, through which you see with the both eyes. Now what you can do there, you can say this is the first photographs and this is the second photograph. These two photographs are consecutively taken by the aircraft, and they are taken together, and they are superimposed such that 60% is the overlap is obtained. Now last time, if you remember, I told you how you make you assure that the 60% your overlap is obtained. You may have to take the trials one to two trials, and we are just keeping the object, a finger on the object on the first photograph, and on the same object, if you are keep putting your finger on the same object and bringing the two photographs such that your two fingers, they will be lying one above another. So because of the fusioning, fusing of these two objects or two points, that's how you can generate the 3D diagrams. To understand it more clearly, some of the numericals, they may appear in the exam. So we will take a very simple problem, which is taken in the from the book itself. Mostly the theoretical question that will be appear in the exam, that will, what is meant by the scale of vertical photograph. So this is a theoretical question, but along this it may be also asked, determine the scale of photograph for terrain lying at elevation of 50 meters and 20 meters. If vertical photograph was taken at altitude of 1200 meters, take focal length of camera at 15 centimeter. Now this problem, you first of all is very simple. What is the give data is given, we have to accordingly first draw the diagram and depict there in the diagram what is the HA, what is the HB, what is the relative positions of A and B. So here in this diagram, very first thing is that we have to calculate the scale of the photographs. So the elevation of two different points is given, which is at 50 meters and 200. That means if I say in the diagram, this is your datum. So with respect to the datum, the two points, if I say point A, which is of the 50 meters above the datum, and another point which is the 200 meters. So this is the point HB. Now the photograph, these are mostly the photographs are the vertical photographs. In your syllabus, no oblique photographs will be for the study purpose. Therefore, no numericals on the oblique photographs. Here, if I say this is your exposure point, so from the datum to the exposure point, this is your flying height, which is capital H and given as a 1200 meters. Now one more data is called the focal length, and the focal length usually is very small as compared to the all other distances. So this is 15 centimeter, that means you are this much distance. So from the exposure, to the this plane, so this is your positive plane, and this is your above, this is your negative plane. This will also having the same as a smaller, which is focal length, but this is not required for us. Mostly we are interested because this is the actually plane where the photographs are generated, and this generated photograph are useful for us to find out what is the photo based distance. Now if you see from this, if I say that capital H is your the flying height, so this one is a capital H minus small h b. Similarly, this one is also small h minus small h. So what is the remaining distance up to the exposure station from the point and point B respectively are shown in this diagram. The scale at any height h is given here. So you have to remember this formula, and this formula is very simple to remember. If I say S, it stands for the scale of photographs for given height, and F is the focal length, H and this small h that we are going to calculate. So H is for what point we have to consider. Suppose we are writing for A point, we have to calculate the A point, because scale will be changing as the elevation of the point changing. So therefore, if we want to show the uniform photograph scale or uniform scale, so the average of the height will also be equal to the average height. So H is equal to 50 meters. So therefore, H 50 is equal to, now this F is value is your 15 centimeter. You may convert it into 50 into or divided by centimeters into converting by meter by 100. Similarly, 1200 meters and 50 meters. If you say that, now this is the value coming out to be 1 centimeter is equal to 74.67 meters. As a representative fraction, also you can write. So there are two ways to write, express this is the one of the scale type, and this is the representative fraction. So here you can write as 1 as 2. So you can convert this meter into centimeter. So say 74.67 multiplied by 100. So that will get the scale of this. Now we will see one more problem. A straight length of highway AB appears to be 12.5 cm on a vertical AF photograph of 15 cm focal length. The corresponding distance of the highway on a 1:2 50,000 topographical map is 6.25 cm. Assuming the average elevation of the terrain as 1250 meters above mean sea level, calculate the flying height of the camera above mean sea level. So it is very clear that we have to calculate the capital H above mean sea level. Now to start with this, the problem is little different with the previous one. Here there is a highway, the camera is taken, the photograph is taken, where the highway in the photographs is from one end to another, if it is A to B, so AB length given my measure to be 12.5 centimeter and the focal length is 15 centimeter given. Now the scale, the photograph has different scale, but if you say consider the scale of 1:50,000 for the same photograph, it will have the distance AB is equal to 6.25 centimeters. Try to understand this problem. In the original photograph scale, which is not given in this problem and which is also not necessary, that was 12.5 centimeters. So original, the camera with which the photographs were taken, and on that photographs, the AB highway length was measured on that photograph was 12.5 centimeter. Now if the same photograph is to be represented with the scale of 1:50,000, then this will come out as or measured was 6.25 centimeters. Now the average elevation of terrain is 1250 meters. As I said that as points are different, so different points are there like this. So this is taken as the average mean sea level. And with respect to this, somewhere here is your point, and this height is given as a capital H. I know that this is not the true picture. Average elevation does not give you the true picture, but some extent it can be considered. Now to start with this, what is the scale of photograph? If we say the scale of the photograph is equal to the length of line AB on photograph and the length of line AB on the ground. Okay, now the length of line AB on photograph, that was 12.5 centimeters, so we have written as a 12.5 centimeter. Now the same photograph, if we measure with the 1:50,000, so I can write the 50,000, but the distance was measured as 6.25, therefore we have to multiply it by this 6.25. So therefore original the scale of the vertical photograph, that will be come out as 1:25,000. After having calculated this scale, we know the formula for the scale is equal to, so scale S is equal to F upon H minus capital H minus H average. Now scale we have already calculated, so therefore we want to know what is the H. So H is equal to, this length is given to us as the focal length, mostly it is as a 15 centimeter, that is 0.15 meters, and the average height is given as a 1250. Okay, so therefore, if we say if we want to calculate the height will be with respect to datum. Just understand it clearly. These are the different points. Now this is your exposure point. This is your H average. Last time I just wrongly expressed this. And here is the datum line. Because datum line is the same as a mean sea level, and here is the exposure point. Okay. Now this is your H. I'm very sorry, last time I showed you this is the capital H from here, but it is actually with respect to here. And this is your H average, because points are different at different elevation. This one, like this. So therefore, just doing the calculations, the only unknown point is your H. So from this you can calculate the H is equal to 5000 meters. So what is the camera exposure point here? About the mean sea level is up to 5000 meters. This is the last problem that we will take. It is very similar to first one. A line AB measures 11 cm on photographs taken with a camera having focal length is equal to 21.5 cm. The same line measures 3 cm on a map drawn to a scale 1:45,000. Calculate the flying height of the aircraft if the average altitude is 350 meters. So last, the previous one, the problem we have solved, the problem is very similar this one also. Only the values are changing. You can see here 11 centimeter, which is measured with the actual photographs taken by the camera. Then the focal length is given 21.5 centimeter, and the same line if you measure, now with this it will have 3 cm, but the scale also changes, that is from 1:45,000 to 1:45,000. So therefore, if the average altitude is 350, so what will be the flying height, that is capital H, that we want to calculate. So using the same formula, scale is equal to F upon H minus. So what you need to do, first of all, calculate the scale, and this scale calculated, you have to compare with this scale. The normal scale can be expressed as length of AB on photographs and length of the AB on the ground. So that can be calculated, scale of photographs, you can calculate this very easily. Taking this value scale and this value, so from this you can calculate what is the value as such. Okay, so try to solve this. Now we will see in the next lecture few of the problems related to how to calculate the elevation difference when the air based distance or photo based distance is given. Thank you very much.